I like the look of bold graphic lettering on a journal page, and today I'll show you how to achieve that using Sakura's Permapake and Jelly Roll pens. There's a myriad of colors, and we can create all kinds of cool combinations using the two types of pens. The technique is an extension of your own style of writing or printing, and I know you're going to have fun with it. Permapake pens are opaque pigment markers made to work on a variety of surfaces, starting with paper. They work on wood, glass, ceramic, metal, and plastic. This particular style of pen has two ends. We have this bullet tip, which will provide a reasonably thin line. We have this nice big fat chisel tip that's going to provide us with three surfaces. We'll have this broad surface here, we'll have this narrower one here, and we'll utilize that a second way to get a thin line. So starting with the broad tip, we can get a really thick line. We'll switch now and we'll work with this one here. And you can see that we get a line that's not straight, but it's thinner. And then if I turn the marker to utilize that chisel edge, I'm going to get a much thinner line. And we can use this to our advantage as we draw letters and shapes. So starting with the broad side, here's a really thick, fat U. Now I'll switch over to the other side of that tip and make a U again, and it's thinner. And now I'll turn the marker and utilize that chisel edge, and you can see that I've got a much thinner U. We're going to combine this with Jelly Roll pens, metallic, stardust, all kinds of fun things to get really interesting looks with our letters and our borders. Working with the chisel tip, let's try some basic lettering, just uppercase block letters, and you can use any three of the sides that we've already talked about to either make fat parts of the letter or you can make them skinnier, whichever works. So if you want to utilize the broad tip of the pen, you can come in and create an A that looks like this, and then you utilize the narrower sides of the marker tip as well. And it really does just depend on what you want to do. You can do uppercase letters, you can do lowercase letters. And as I mentioned earlier, this is really just going to be an extension of the way you normally form letters. So just play and scribble and sit down like you were back in grade school again and make letters over and over and over again. The way to get consistently good at it is to practice. Once you're satisfied with what you're doing, what you can do is pick up a Jelly Roll pen, and here's where the really fun, colorful part begins. What I'm going to do is outline the various parts of this letter, and then I can think about how else I can embellish them. Now you'll notice, despite the fact that I went off a little bit up there, by outlining, I kind of clean up any ragged edges, and I'm not looking for perfection here. I just want some fun, colorful lettering for my journals. And when I get through, I think, well, okay, this looks kind of cool, but what can I do to kind of kick it up a little bit? And I can come in and I can put some lines. If I want, I can put some dots. And you can create sort of a whole customized alphabet doing this with all kinds of variations of your own handwriting and these letters. So practice and play and see what you can come up with. Now we're going to use the bullet end of the pen to do some more lettering. And typically when I do this, I find myself working in lowercase letters. And of course, you can use this to make uppercase or block style letters. It really is just a matter of personal preference. And when I letter this way, rather than making an A like this, I tend to make an A like this because it gives me lots of room to go ahead and outline. And so if I were sort of making an alphabet sampler, I'd come in and I'd make a B that looks something like this. And again, this is just sort of my own version of letters and how I go ahead and create them. Yours are going to look different from this, although of course you're welcome to mimic and do what I do. You'll eventually develop your own style anyway, even if it just sort of resembles mine, and that's fine. I mean, you'll figure this out as you go along, and I'm going to make another B here because I didn't leave enough room to make a D, and you will develop your own way of making these letters. All right, let's try a D here now that I've remembered to actually leave some room. And I like to come along, and I like these sort of fat and thin areas. And this becomes very effective when I add the Jelly Roll pens and I do the outlining. Now, you don't need to see me make the whole alphabet from A to Z, but what we can do now is come in and outline. And much like when we were working on the uppercase block style letters, the outlining, when you're paying attention and you're not trying to talk when you're doing it, provides a kind of finished edge to your letters. And I sort of sometimes tend to make these a little bit more curvy because I have the ability to do that more simply with the Jelly Roll pens than I do with the Permapaque pens. But this is where you can kind of come in and get fun with your letters. Sort of add little curly cues or whatever it is that you want to do. And once again, I could come back in and I can put some dots in these letters if I want. I can put some stripes in these letters. I mean, there's all kinds of fun things that you can do. In fact, you can do combinations of them if you want. And again, this is also where you'll find your own style and you'll find how you like to go ahead and letter your, or embellish rather, your letters. There's all different kinds of ways that you can do that. In fact, if you want to combine multiple colors with your pens, you could do that as well. I could come in with this pink Jelly Roll pen and do my embellishments with it rather than with the purple that I used to outline. So let your imagination run and just sit down and practice and play, and you'll be amazed at what you can come up with. Let's go back to the chisel end of the marker and create some borders. Lots of different things that you can do. You can utilize that really broad end of the marker if you want. And then, of course, the fun comes in when we bring in one of the Jelly Roll pens. Just by outlining these blocks gives it an entirely different look. And this is very loose and very, very free-flowing. And so if there's a little bit of white here or there, or if this is not quite perfect, that's just sort of the nature of what I'm doing. And then I can have fun by coming in and putting dots if I want. I can divide this up if I want. There's all different kinds of things that I can do. I can come up here and work on one of these and outline it. I can do spirals. I can just come in and do dots. You can see that there's just all kinds of ways to have fun with this. Now I have a tag prepped, so let me show you on a tag how much fun this can be. I'm just going to start in one corner with a circle. Come in and grab a Jelly Roll now, and again, just sort of that same loose, free-flowing look. I think this makes a really fun border, and it's very easy, but I think it's very, very effective. The last thing we're going to do is take a look at Permapaque pens on fabric. Did you know that you can use these on fabric? You can, and the best part, they're not going to bleed when we use them. Let's talk now about using the permopaque markers on fabric. The amazing thing is that when you write with them, unlike probably virtually every other marker that you'll ever use on fabric, you'll see that there's no bleeding off of that line. It's nice and crisp, just as it was if I had put it down on paper. Again, I can use the broad side of the marker. I can use that little chisel side of the marker to get a thinner line. I can make letters. Now, obviously, working on fabric presents a slightly different challenge because paper doesn't do this when you work on it, but you can put your hand in there and you can hold it taut, and you can get almost as good results on fabric as you do on paper. So don't limit yourself to thinking only paper when you're working with these markers, and remember that they work on glass, they work on ceramic, they work on plastic, they'll work on wood, they'll work on a nice variety of things for you. When you combine them with the Jelly Roll markers, you have a really winning combination. Permopaque and Jelly Roll, both made by Sakura, both fantastic products.